Babe, I love you. You're my favorite person. I got the doves, I got the loot, I got the I got the sauce, I got the Damn. What's going on, guys?
Hi.
How are you? How you guys doing?
Good. We are the morning show that works together and quarantines together.
There you go.
We don't mind spending all the time together.
Got you. Where you guys from?
We're in Tampa.
Oh, cool. What have you guys been up to during quarantine? Have you guys been doing a lot of radio shows and stuff?
Oh yeah.
We do so much talking. It's a little, I don't know if anybody wants to hear us anymore, but we do the show, we do a podcast every day, and then we just talk to each other. So
you guys ever get sick of each other or?
Yeah.
Well,
I'm just joking.
So here's the awkward dynamic is that Holly and I have worked together since 2008 and right. We lived together the first 5 years. And now she has a little girl.
I got pregnant and he was like, see you later. I'm going to move out now. And I was like, okay, so it's fine. So now, made my little baby. And then Scott joined the show. And now he lives with Miguel.
Yeah.
Aww. So you guys spend a lot of time together.
Like a lot of time.
A lot of time.
All the time.
Too much time.
So, obviously in life it's good to have balance. Where do you guys find the balance to get space and do your own thing? Do you guys have that?
Well, Holly, you... No, I mean, Holly... It is... I mean, Holly is here now because after this, we're going on to our Facebook page to have a little happy hour with our listeners. And so, I mean... We really spend all of our time together, but that's what makes us such like a close-knit circle is that we don't, I mean, we live together, so Scott may get sick of me sometimes.
I can go hang out in my room and I just leave.
Yeah.
It's not that big though. That's a small space.
I need my time. It's probably good though. There's probably benefits in it too. Just having the social aspect and having each other to talk to. I'm sure that's, probably good too.
Right. For me, I think it has helped keep like quarantine pandemic kind of sane because this is like normal for me. You know what I mean? So exactly. it's okay. And so like for you, and obviously it's like you and Haley in the house, but do you have other people that are just in there with you, like that help you guys out? And are you sick of them or how does that work for you?
That's a good question. We have a chef, which we're super blessed to have because I feel like that's a big, I feel like stressor, food, just even the conversation with your significant other of what are we gonna eat? I want this, you want that, or usually it's just you choose, you make the decision. No, you choose. And so having a chef, make that decision helps us a lot. So
Does the chef choose sometimes?
No, that's what I mean. It helps having the chef to choose to make
it.
Yeah, that's what I mean by that.
So how does that work to like at 5 o'clock, does he say, hey, we're having lamb tonight or we're having burgers tonight? How does that work?
So it's Chef Kiki and it's a girl and she's the best. And she basically has, because I have a few dietary restrictions, I don't eat gluten and certain things like that. Mm-hmm. And then I try to do a certain amount of protein and stuff. So she kind of just follows a list.
Oh, that's nice.
So can we get Chef Kiki?
Yeah,
could she come to Tampa when you come?
Man, she's the best. We love her so much.
Love that.
Wait, I have a dumb question. Does gluten, does that involve Doritos? Is that?
Yeah. Well, I believe probably it has gluten. Maybe in the, it usually says gluten free on the actual package. I don't believe Doritos are gluten free.
I don't think so.
Do you not eat Doritos? Do you?
I would eat Doritos if it was a special day and I was, out and there was nothing around. I'm not like so to the point where I don't make any exceptions.
Okay, so real quick though, we have to know are you like team Cool Ranch or are you team Nacho Cheese? Don't get yourself. Don't
sorry,
because
well, we were having this debate before we talked to you because I just went grocery shopping and I got Nacho Cheese and Holly loves Cool Ranch.
So what do you mean? I like Cool Ranch.
And I'm like, I'm on an island all by myself.
So I think I feel like if I was to eat Doritos consistently, I would be the original. I think it's Nacho Cheese. Is that what yours are?
Yeah. Okay.
But I don't know if you guys have it, but in Canada they have a flavor called Zesty.
Ooh.
What is that?
Zesty Doritos, and it's like they're not spicy, but they got like a tang to them. They're fire, but they're only in Canada.
Yeah, I was gonna say Zesty on the back, Doritos. All they have is like spicy, sweet chili, dynamite. What the?
The heck? The sweet chili ones are good.
Yeah, they are. Yeah, they are.
The sweet chili ones are fire. Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, so I do have to ask before, because I know you have a lot going on today, is we were talking about when we were watching the earlier interviews and when you told Haley to get your cord, and we were like, that echo in that house, how long does it take for you to like run to your room and back to where you are now?
It's not, I think it's just it's just high ceilings, that's why. It's actually not very far. She's in the bedroom right through that door there.
Oh, ooh, I love that wall. It's a good wall.
Thank you. This is my living room kitchen area.
Ooh.
We don't have any TV in here because we like to, I don't know, not have a TV in this area. But we have a little TV in the kitchen.
Okay.
Wait, so when y'all are hanging out in the living room, like, are y'all not watching TV or what are you doing?
So when we're in the living room, we like to play games, like board games, word games, and put on a fire. And then if we want to go, we have a movie theater room downstairs, so if we want to go to watch a movie, we just go.
That's where you watch the movie. Yeah, that's where you watch it. Like, when you were watching, like, I don't know, like, Tiger King or something, you're in the movie room, and the tigers are like...
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was fun. But hey,
fire is the best, though.
I gotta keep moving on with some more people, but it was so nice and really enjoyable talking to you three, and I hope to see you guys soon. Tampa,
absolutely.
Right?
Tampa? We can't wait. Tampa, yep. We can't wait to see you in Tampa.
Can't wait to see you guys in Tampa.
Alrighty, have a good weekend.
Bye.
Bye, guys. Take care. There we go.
There you are.
I'm so sorry for all the inconvenience.
Hey, it's all good. I haven't seen you in a while, so it's good to see you from afar. How are you?
It's good to see you too. Good. How's the family? How's everybody
good?
Doing?
Everybody's good. We're just bored. How are you guys?
We're good. How many people you got in the house right now?
So me, my husband, my son, and my dog. This is Say hi to Justin. I can't decide if he loves that we're home or if he's just like, get out of my space.
Yeah.
Where's your dog? Boy.
What kind of dog is it?
So we rescued him, so we're not sure, but we think he's a Rhodesian Ridgeback mixed with like Lab Pit.
Definitely a little bit of Rhodesian Ridgeback. I definitely see that.
Yeah, he is the best animal ever.
Beautiful.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, our dog is hiding in shame because Haley gave it the worst haircut of life.
I saw that picture and it didn't look that bad. What was wrong with it?
It's because we put a coat on it. It's like she tried to buzz it, but she used my face clippers.
Okay.
And basically it just has a bunch of bald spots. It's just it's not good.
I need a haircut too, so she can do mine.
Yeah, I don't know. You by the looks of the dog, you would not want to get your haircut by.
Okay.
So you've been in quarantine. You're with your family. Do you guys do any board games? Do you guys like doing things as a family? What have you guys been doing as a family?
We've been watching Disney Plus. So, like, my son is, like, just able to watch TV now. So, like, we've been binging, like, movies and stuff, basically. And we did, like, I should have brought it in here. We did a, like, Lego Ferrari thing the other day. And it's, like, a billion pieces, which is not my thing, doing Legos like that. So, that took, like, 10 hours.
Dang.
He's not impressed by this.
Nah, but, Legos, man. I haven't played with Legos since I was a kid. So you had to get the thing and put them all together and like follow the instructions and do that whole thing.
Like it's so many pieces that like they bag it up and like here's section 1, 2, 3, 4. Like it was. Yeah. I basically watched while they did it, but it's it's wild. Awesome.
What other mom stuff have you been doing?
Like walking around the neighborhood. That's about it. That's walking, awesome. Coloring, yeah, just coloring. Doing whatever. More Legos.
How old are how many kids?
Just one. He's almost two, so he like watches Disney Junior and like you know cute little shows like that.
What's his favorite thing to watch?
Mickey and the Mickey's. They just changed the name, but it's like Mickey and he like races cars and stuff.
Aww.
Mickey's Mixed Up Adventures, I think, is what it's called. So
they have so many Mickey shows. It's crazy.
They're so good. But he will sing Intentions and like ask for it already, and he's not even two, which is crazy. So thank you for that music.
Absolutely. Well, I appreciate you guys playing it, and it was an enjoyable, fun time talking to you.
Yeah, good to see you again.
Okay, good to see you.
Talk to you later.
Bye.
Bye, Justin.
Take care. Ooh. Found you guys. Found Pop Crush.
Hi, Justin.
Hello. How are you?
How are you?
Good.
I'm Kayla from Pop Crush.
I'm Justin. Have we met before?
No, we haven't.
I always have to ask because in the past I've met so many people and I tend to forget sometimes. So
I'm sure you meet thousands and thousands of people all the time. Look, yeah. Milo wants to meet you. I saw the girl before me had a dog. I was like, oh, my cat.
His name's Milo?
It's Milo.
Oh, that's such a cute name. Hi, Milo. He's unimpressed, too. He's like, put me down, Mom.
He just woke up from a nap. That's why he's like.
So cute. I love cats. Yeah, I have a couple cats in California. Really? And, a friend of mine's watching them, but. I'm in Canada right now. Where did you say you're located at right now?
So I'm in Maryland right now, but I work out of Jersey. I came back to Maryland to like quarantine with my family because I just didn't want to do it alone. I'm here. I do the show from my closet and that's about it.
That's what everyone seems to be doing because it's the best for sound, right?
Yeah, because it's like if I do it anywhere else, it's like echoey. So I got.
Or you got to put like a blanket over top of you. You know what I mean?
Yep. My microphone is in between pillows. And then my clothes, like, muffle the sound. It's perfect.
That's awesome. So you're being productive in this time. That's really awesome.
Yeah. What have you been doing?
I've been actually making music. I've been recording some songs and making some music. Yeah. So it's been really productive as well on my end. So
I was thinking because before this, I was on your cat's Instagram.
Oh, yeah.
And I was like, this is a perfect time for people to – start fostering animals. And absolutely. So I was thinking about doing that with all this free time.
Haley was talking about that too. She's like, I wish we were in LA, I would foster an animal right now. She's like, I want to bottle feed a dog, a baby dog or a baby cat.
That's what me and my family are talking about. It's like, why not? We have all this time and like people are more and more people are fostering, animals now. So
yeah. What have you been watching on TV?
I've been watching a lot of Instagram live stuff. So
awesome.
And those Instagram live battles that they've been doing. Have you seen Lil Jon and T-Pain?
I heard of it. I heard of them, but I haven't seen them yet. Are they pretty cool?
You haven't seen any?
No, they're
who
cool.
Would you like to go head to head? Ooh, in an Instagram battle. Who would you like to see?
Like, who would I like to see, huh? I would like to see, like, Jay-Z and Lil Wayne go head-to-head. That would be tight.
Oh, that would be perfect.
Or Beyonce and Rihanna go head-to-head would be tight.
That would be a good one. That would be a
Beyonce
good one.
Beyonce and Rihanna would be so tight.
That, I don't, you couldn't even choose between the two of them.
It'd be too hard. They're two both so hard.
Yeah. It's not even like, it's a celebration of music. It's not like you're pitting them up against each other. It's exactly. Just like everybody wins. It's all, everyone's good.
Exactly.
If you could do an Instagram live battle, who do you think
if that I could battle anyone? I wouldn't want to like go against anybody because it's hard because like music isn't about like being better or worse than somebody else's. It's about like
celebrating music.
Celebrating life and music and art and stuff. So I don't really think it should be a challenge.
Right. I would love to see you and Chris Brown because you guys are both equally like amazing.
Thank you.
And I think that would be dope.
That would be cool. Yeah. I've always looked up to him and his music and I think he's a great guy.
I also wanted to tell you that I so appreciate how you are like bringing your fans into a whole new genre when it comes to like gospel music. You know, I love how you have your church, you stream your, you know, church services live on Instagram.
Yeah.
You get on here and sing gospel music. And I just think that is like, especially in this time, that is absolutely what people need.
Thank you. Yeah. It's what gets me through, you know, my journey in life. And so it's really important that I am honest with that. And, you know, sometimes it's hard to express your faith because you're afraid of what people would think. But I think when you step out and you're just being yourself and you say, this is what I believe, and you don't have to believe what I believe, but this is what I believe, and maybe it'll help you and maybe it doesn't, but just being honest with your journey, I think is
important, And I think that's why people love you so much is because you like have been so transparent and so honest about that journey. Thank you. Like bringing your fans along with you, and it's amazing to see. And it also invites other people to be like, oh, what is this, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. So I think that's cool. Saying that. That means a lot.
No problem. One last question, though. So you know all these social media challenges.
Yeah.
Why hasn't Usher's Prodigy done the Climax challenge yet?
Damn. I was going to do it the other day, and I just forgot. I should probably do it.
We need it.
I'm going to do it. I'll do it this week.
Please do, because you would body it for sure.
Thank you for saying that. I'm going to do that. All right, well, it's nice to meet you, and I hope you have a wonderful rest.
It was nice to meet you, too.
Yeah, pleasure.
You, too.
You're the best.
Bye.
Take care. Bert, I got you on here. You should be accepting it. Damn.
My dude. Oh,
there they are.
My dude.
What's up, fam?
What are you doing, man?
Long time no see.
Dude, you know how like you made me feel so
old? Hey, bud.
Hey. You made me feel so old last time we were on. The last time you saw this dude, he was 5 years old.
Damn, no way.
Yeah.
Is this your son too?
Yeah, this is my oldest son.
Dang, how you been, man?
Good.
Good. It's good to see you again. How you been?
Well,
how old are you now?
17.
Dang.
You're old.
Damn. And you were 5 last time I seen you?
I think 5 or 6 at least.
You were in Nashville. You were in Nashville. We flew up just for the concert in Nashville, met you beforehand, said hey, and then we flew back down just so we could meet you.
That's awesome, man. It's good to see you again, bro.
You too.
How have you been? You guys been good? What have you guys been up to? You guys been hanging a lot?
Yeah. We haven't been doing a whole lot because, you know, the apocalypse is upon us, so.
I know. You can call it that. That's for sure. It's been pretty crazy.
I don't know. How are you crushing hours in the middle of the day, man? Like, I used to say that the days were super long and, I mean, super short, and now they're just super long. Like, what are you doing?
Man, well, I try to – I've been trying to switch my sleeping schedule around and get up really early and work in the morning, work out early in the morning, and record some music in the morning, and then try to get to bed early. But it's just this whole quarantine has you just so mixed up. It's just hard to stick to any sort of schedule, you know?
Yeah. He's getting, what, you get in bed like 2 in the morning now and getting up at like 2 in the afternoon.
Yeah. Haley's like that.
Yeah.
Haley's, and just, she was just talking about she wants to get her schedule back. But
I don't know, man. I wish I knew when to back was, you know?
How are you working in this time? How are you doing your radio show?
So there's 4 people on the show, like, you know, so we're all doing it from our different houses. So it's kind of been a cluster, man. It's hard to do a show when you're not talking all over each other. We're doing the best we can, you know?
And are you guys connecting? Is it like it's not live, right? It's pre-recorded.
No, it's live.
So who's, it's live.
Yeah.
How are you doing it? That seems crazy. So you can hear them talk live and like, it's the whole thing.
It's like a Zoom call, man. Yeah, and it just goes out over all of our stations. Yeah, it's crazy.
Do you find like you're talking over each other or?
So we do this thing where if anybody has anything to say, they just raise their hand and then I choose them so we're not like all over each other.
I know. Dang. It's just complicated. So complicated. Yeah.
It is. So are you getting up in the morning and working on stuff? Or are you getting up in the morning and just working out or what are you doing?
Yeah, so I got up this morning. I did a workout with my trainer, Carlin, Dr. Carlin Coker. He's a trainer out of Greenwich, Connecticut.
Yeah,
and so he specializes in he's a doctor, but he's also like he's like a bodybuilder, you know. And so he got Shaq back in shape when Shaq got hurt back in the day. And he came back and won a bunch of championships. He's like trains a lot of UFC fighters and he's just like super like so passionate about what he does. So I get up in the morning and he's like, this is the meat and potatoes nobody wants to do. And he's like pushing me to the max. So it's good, man. He's good shit.
Are you just trying to get all cut up just for the sake of getting cut up or is it what's the intent?
Well, I want to be like with what I do, I need to be really explosive with performing because you're like, you're here, you're on a toaster, right? And then you got to pop up, run to one side of the stage. I mean, it's a lot more cardio and physical stuff than people really realize. And dancing, you got a lot of body movement. So I got to be really explosive. And when this is all said and done, which I hope is sooner than later, I'm going to be back on tour. You know what I mean? So I want to be able to, you know, be in shape and not be a bum when I come out of this thing.
Right. Are you and Haley like getting like? Are there little things that you're doing that she's annoyed by? Like my girlfriend the other day told me that she didn't realize how loud I chewed crackers the other day.
Oh, it's literally everything. I mean, it's little everything. Both of us. It's like all these little things. My breath stinks all the time, and like I just brushed my teeth. She's like, I came out and eat a piece of chicken last night. She's like, you smell like chicken. I'm like, I ate chicken. What do you want from me, woman?
So it's little like things that didn't bother you before, man, that are just like on your nerves.
It's just building up. So much time together spent, but it's a good test to our relationship, and it's been really good.
100%, man. Well, you look good, dude.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it. You guys look good too.
It's good seeing you, man. Be safe, be healthy. All right.
Absolutely, guys. Hey, good seeing you, bud.
Gina too.
Take care. Hi, guys.
Bye.
I don't know which ones we got left, but. Damn. Cool. I'm gonna do this. What's going on, brother?
How we doing, my man?
How are you, man? Have we spoken on here before?
No, sir. No, sir.
How are you today, man?
I'm well. I just got done with a day of work. Made myself a little quarantine meal.
Yeah. What are you eating?
Dude.
Let me see what you got going on there.
Rice.
Oh man, it froze, sorry. Froze on us. Dang.
Let's see.
It was spinning. Wheel spinning. All right, let me see. There you Ooh. Go. Nice. Yeah,
hold up.
Nice, pretty healthy meal for quarantine. Did you cook, you cooked it yourself?
Yes, sir. Should we get a little jam session going?
Where are you from? Sure.
Detroit.
Where are you from? It's hard. Honestly, it's really hard to do jam sessions because of the latency, and you're really delayed.
How about now?
Unfortunately, but I'd love to hear you play some if you want.
How about me and my roommate play a little something for you?
I'd love to hear you and your roommate.
My guy Justin Bieber.
What's up, Biebs?
How are you, sir?
Here, wait. Let me take the phone.
I'd love to hear you guys riff on something if that's cool.
You want to riff on something?
Sure. Let's do it.
No pressure. No pressure.
Let's do it.
Let's hear it.
It's my buddy Justin.
What kind of music do you guys play and make?
You know, I'm not the mediocre kind.
The mediocre kind, yeah.
I try to keep pretty cool. Bennett's all over the board. Yeah. But
you guys enjoy it though, right? It brings joy to your soul, so that's good.
Exactly, always.
Yeah, man. Hey, well, maybe if we get a beat going and you can do it, you can maybe sing over it.
Okay. We're delayed in quarantine. We're delayed. Quarantine. What's up, though? Five. vibes.
Sweet.
Vibes, bro. So good.
Yeah, bro. Hey, appreciate you. This is my other roommate, Sarah.
Hi, how are you?
We're in San Francisco right now.
Awesome. Well, enjoy your time in quarantine and keep making music. It makes a lot of people happy.
Cool.
Good job, man. Good plan.
Have a good day.
All right, guys. Take care.
Cheers.
Yeah. All right, guys. That was it. We did a little radio thing, and now we talked to a few fans. I'm tired. I gotta eat, do something. Maybe I'll play you guys something. Give me the itch. Those boys playing. Good job, by the way, guys.
Picture perfect, you don't need no filter. Go just make them drop dead, you a killer. Picture perfect, you don't need no filter. Go just make them drop dead, you a killer. Shower you with all my intentions. Yeah, these are my only intentions. In the kitchen, cooking up, get your own bread. Heart full of equity, I'm an asset. Make sure that you don't need no mansions. Yeah, these are my only intentions. Shout out to your mom and dad for making you. Stand in ovation, they did a great job raising you. When I create, you're my muse. The kind of smile that makes the news. Can't nobody throw shade on your name in these streets. So we throw you a boss, you a bay, you a beast. You make it easy to choose. You got a mean touch, you can't refuse. No, I can't refuse it. Picture perfect, you don't need no filter. Go just make them drop dead, you a killer. Shower you with all my intentions. Yeah, these are my only intentions. In the kitchen, cooking up, cut your own bread. Heart full of equity, you're an asset. Make sure that you don't need no mansions. Yeah, these are my only intentions. Shout out to your mom and dad for making you. Standing ovation, they did a great job raising you. When I create, you're my muse. The kind of smile that makes the news. Can't nobody throw shade on your name in these streets. To throw you a boss, you a bear, you a beast. You make it easy to choose. You got a mean touch, you can't refuse. No, I can't refuse it. Picture perfect, you don't need no filter. Go just make them drop dead, you a killer. Shower you with all my intentions. Yeah, these are my only intentions. In the kitchen, cooking up, cut your own bread. Heart full of equity, you're an asset. Make sure that you don't need no mansions. Yeah, these are my only intentions.
Thank you guys. Love you. Take care.